Ron, just for a start, just give me a brief definition of MDM.
Okay, MDM stands for Master Data Management, and that's the ability to bring together different pieces of data to make the best version of a particular entity, so the best version of a customer, the best version of a product, etc.
To master the data, companies need to ask right questions. What are they, and what should companies do in order to get right answers?
So the right questions are really about how are you going to improve the business. So what is the best version of the customer? How do you plan to use that information? Where is it going to come from? And the best way to get that information is really to start from the business requirements and then to figure out what the questions are that get you to the answers.
During your presentation, you comment some business case really interesting about how companies are using MDM and analyze the big data in order to increase revenue, increase loyalty. What are you seeing today regarding these results? And I'd like to comment a little bit on that too.
Okay, so during the presentation, we gave three examples. One of them was General Electric Aviation, so GE Aviation, who has seen a 50% improvement in the overall customer, the overall costs, reduction in the costs of maintaining their customer and product data. And what it's allowed them to do is to actually get a more efficient use of their maintenance facilities to maintain their engines by understanding their products and their customers better. The second use case was Hyatt. Hyatt is a global brand for hotels, and they got about a 20% improvement in revenues generated from their loyalty customers. And then the third example I gave was Renault, the international car manufacturer, who is using master data management to get a better view of the life cycle of both their customers and their vehicles, and to build better campaigns to get additional follow-on revenues. And they saw an 80% improvement in 80% reduction in the manual labor they have to do to get their information correct to build better campaigns, and they can leverage that same resource against actually interacting with customers.
What is the key for companies to get results like that? What is your advice?
So our advice is always to start from understanding your business requirements and to work backwards from there. So understand what it is you're trying to accomplish, focus on those things, and then design use the technology available to achieve those business results.
Changing a little bit of subject, how Internet of Things will completely change or make it more complex of big data and MDM?
So the Internet of Things is definitely a big data type of operation, and what is changing is changing the very nature of business problems. It's allowing companies to do things that they just couldn't do before, to get more understanding of their customers, to get a better understanding of all of the interactions of their customers, but better than that, to understand how their customers influence other customers and how other customers influence them. And so we're seeing a lot of companies that are building brand new business models based on being able to get to the Internet of Things.
And this is because machines are talking between each other, so they are bringing new kind of data from machines that they just couldn't get before?
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of cases. It's exactly the point. We're seeing a lot of cases where this information that's available at individual levels, like the product in a store, being able to communicate with individuals. So being able to offer something to somebody with a mobile phone just as they come by based on their preferences. Those are the types of things that we're seeing now.
And how do you think this big data analysis of Internet of Things will change companies that are already set today? And how will they bring it possible to exist another kind of companies that we don't have today?
So we're seeing that transform all the time. So you are seeing companies like Uber, like Airbnb, companies like that are just changing their entire business model based on the ability to understand how things relate to people and how people relate to locations. So, you know, Uber is a great example that has eliminated the ownership of vehicles. They don't own any vehicles at all, and they manage everything through just the underlying data. Their next version is to get rid of their drivers and to use automated cars that the Internet of Things is going to enable.